Thank you, thank you. First, let's give a round of applause to all the speakers tonight. They were all excellent. Right, thank you. Yes. And a second round of applause for the Effect team and Amplify for hosting this wonderful event. So yeah, I came here to talk about NeoVim. Just kidding. I have got off the past 3 months of giving quite a few conference talks, and the most recent one ended in Alicante, Spain, a few weeks ago. I was speaking at React Alicante, put a lot of work into that talk. Woke up the next morning, was having coffee on my balcony, hadn't looked at my phone yet, just looking at the beautiful water. I looked down, I have a DM from Mike. Will you speak at the Effect meetup? And I said, I will do it under the condition that I do not have to write another slide deck. Yeah, thank you, thank you. So I didn't really know what I was going to talk about. I have a high-level goal of what I want to talk about, and I think it's quite fitting to follow a bunch of the talks tonight. And if anyone has seen anything I talk about on Twitter or Twitch, this is very much like in my wheelhouse. I kind of want to talk about, the past, present, and future of not only TypeScript, but kind of myself as a developer. So, as some context and background on me, I am currently a software engineer at Vercel. I've been working in TypeScript, JavaScript, Node, React, GraphQL, all that stuff, going into my 11th year. Been writing JavaScript since I was 13, so even longer. Despite my baby face, I am over the age of 30. So I've been doing this quite a while. And throughout the years of writing lots and lots and lots of TypeScript and JavaScript and Node and all this stuff, you run into the same problems over and over again. And I should say that I also did consulting for 6.5 years. And the thing with consulting is consultants aren't hired when things are going well. It's not, rainbows and unicorns. It's normally you're getting dropped into like a dumpster fire of a code base and you have to fix things up. And throughout that time, like I was saying, you just see the same exact problems over and over and over again. And, as much as I have made my career off of JavaScript and TypeScript, and I have my deepest expertise in this language, it is also like probably the most frustrating language to work in, and the most frustrating and hard language to ship quality, stable production software with. I think it has the lowest barrier of entry of most languages or stacks, which is an amazing, amazing property of the language and our community, but it's also lends itself to focusing on the happy path too easily, neglecting errors, like all the things we've already heard tonight, right? And you see this over and over and over again. And I've had the privilege across many companies through consulting and working at Vercel and working at Formidable. I've had the real lucky opportunities to work with some of the best JS and TS devs in the world. And even they are not immune from making these mistakes. So that's kind of where Effect comes in. And I think Effect really can be the answer to that. As I had gone through my career journey prior to my job at Vercel, which I just started at in February, I was working at a company for just about 2 years where I got hired as the lead front-end dev at this institutional DeFi company. I'm not a crypto person, but it was still a blast to work at. I got hired to lead basically all the front end JavaScript, TypeScript, React, all that stuff. However, Jesus, shouldn't have sat down here. I've been a full stack dev my entire career, genuinely, and I plan to continue being a full stack dev at the position. But this company built all of their services and a few of their other web apps and even an Excel plugin with OCaml. Yes, so this is where I get functional programming pilled. I spend the past 2 years diving into OCaml. I am writing web apps that compile with Melange to JavaScript. I'm shipping NPM packages, not with PureScript, but with OCaml. I just like fall in love with this language. Like, I had some experience with Elixir back in the day, but nothing, I wasn't at the point of like maturity or, tenure to really understand what functional programming meant and how it could be practical and applied. And then once I got that opportunity to work in OCaml, it just kind of clicked. Working with modules, like the light bulb moment when you finally like have that experience of like what a good type system feels with or feels like. Sorry, TypeScript, but Hindley Milner is just way better. And I've kind of been like chasing that goal of exposing other TypeScript developers that have had that same background, that have my background, right? Like 10 years of TypeScript and JavaScript, and suddenly I get tossed in my head in functional programming. And I think functional programming can get a bad rep, and rightly so. Like, it's easy to like fall into this jargon of monads and functors and trifunctors and all this stuff. And I don't think that's necessarily the value proposition, which I think we can probably all agree on if you're here writing effect. Right. So how do I get to effect? So I start at Vercel. I unfortunately or unfortunately no longer writing OCaml full time. Over the past year, going through my experience learning OCaml from time to time, I would have like these guys from like Effectful show up in my Twitter replies, be like, "Hey, have you seen Effect years? Have you heard of this? Do you want to check this out?" I'm like, it's like the gosh, the meme of the guy in the elevator, like, "I don't even think about you at all." So finally, I'm back into TypeScript world, and Effect 3 comes out. And throughout the past 10 years, despite having worked in TypeScript, the most reliable software I ever shipped was one in OCaml, and second, I worked 2 years in Go. And the first couple of days after React 3 came out, I saw in it a lot of the values and a lot of the properties that I felt building reliable software that wasn't gonna cause me to wake up at 2 in the morning from pages in Effect. So I decided to give it a real shot. And I was that eager junior dev, mid-level dev that saw things like Ramda and FPTS and all these things and wanted to try it. And like, I've made messes with RxJS. I've cleaned up other people's messes in these libraries through consulting for 6.5 years. So I was that person that was insanely skeptical of Effect upfront. And having taken the time to actually build something, multiple things, I've shipped stuff for freelance clients now, I've shipped my own stuff with it. I see the value. I don't want to build without it anymore. So that kind of leads me to like, it's like this, it's not a high you're chasing, but it's like, how do you teach that experience, that light bulb moment that, Elliot, the slide with all the things you love about it, the building with Legos and the composability and just like every single code sample we saw tonight, it looks almost the same. Every single person's Effect code was readable using the same patterns. Once you get down those three or four ways that look unlike anything else, really, in the TypeScript ecosystem, but if you can get that down, you get these beautiful guide rails that lead you to simplicity and simple abstractions that just compose and build up. And it really does feel like building with Legos. I guess like the final part of this is similar to our last speaker's last point. It's like, how do we bridge this gap? How do we get this light bulb moment to more people? And like, that's the thing I've been chasing for 2 years. Getting people to try OCaml or try Gleam or try Effect. And I think we're doing a lot of the right things. I mean, even in the past 8 months, 6 months, I don't even know how long it was since 3.0 came out, but like the quality of the stuff you guys have put out, the doc improvements, like I'm very confident that if there was ever a library and ecosystem to bridge that gap from real world functional programming ideals to TypeScript and more broadly, the entire JavaScript ecosystem, it's going to be this project. And I think we need more people like Elliot who talk about their experience. And I think we need to be real about the things that suck and the things that are hard and the things that are weird. And we need to like not lose sight of when our teammates are like, this is weird, or like, I don't get this. Like, we need to meet them where they're at, because not everyone has had that light bulb moment that it's easy to lose sight of or forget what it was like before that moment. So yeah, I wanna help build with all the rest of you to continue to help bridge that gap and ultimately make better TypeScript software. So thank you.